Australia makes its own decisions regarding China. That was the message to the Trump administration during high-level talks in Washington. China has responded tonight, urging Australia to not go further down the road of harming our relationship, and says it too is committed to regional peace and stability.
A show of strength and unity as politics prevailed in the midst of a pandemic.
Our two great democracies face immediate crises.
Stepping up joint efforts to manage coronavirus and China.
We applaud Australia for pushing back against the CCP's brazen economic threats and coercive behaviour.
Australia's foreign and defence ministers caught in a balancing act on the world stage. How to support our strongest ally without provoking our largest trading partner.
The relationship that we have with China is important, and we have no intention of injuring it. But nor do we intend to do things that are contrary to our interests.
This is about choosing freedom and democracy against tyranny and authoritarian regime.
Australia declined to commit to freedom of navigation operations in the South China Sea, sailing close to disputed territory.
We will continue to transit through the region in accordance with international law.
A new joint task force will monitor disinformation campaigns and cybersecurity.
There was also agreement to collaborate on developing new defence technologies, including hypersonic weapons, while the US is set to boost its investment on Australian soil, setting up a military fuel reserve in Darwin.
The Australian delegation will be hoping it was worth the trip, heading home for 2 weeks in self-isolation.
Not many partners would do that for us, and so thank you to each of you and your teams.
After a unique diplomatic visit in testing times.
This masking with glasses thing is just driving me insane.
In Washington, D.C., Amelia Adams, 9 News.